Well, Croc certainly has been playing a loyal game of Survivor, backing his pal Ben since day dot. But last night, Ben's game became about himself and instead decided to go against his alliance and blow the lid off Croc's plan.
Trust me. You gonna trust me?
Yeah, always trust you.
I've got a plan.
Yeah.
Let me flip this.
Okay.
Yeah?
On who?
Yeah.
On who? Yeah.
Jesse.
Jesse. You know how I said I trust you guys, don't you?
Yeah.
Crocs, we're going to flip this and blindside you tonight. There you go. How's that feel? He wants to save me, but he wants to blindside you.
Ninth person voted out of blood versus water. Croc.
Croc joins us now live from Brisbane. Croc, mate, how devastating was it to be backstabbed by Ben like that?
Yeah, it hurt. Obviously, like any good mother would say, I'm not angry at Ben. I was extremely disappointed, though, especially after trying to flip the votes the night before and get Khan voted out with his idol. I was the only one who didn't write down Ben's name. Jesse and Sam are the ones that orchestrated the blindside, and yeah, unfortunately he chose to align with those guys and not me, and it's unfortunate, but that's the game. And I did have a hidden immunity idol up my sleeve, however I had faith in the plan and I didn't use it, so sadly. Well, silver lining, I'll get to keep it for life, but yeah, it's sad to leave in that fashion.
Yeah, if only Judas, I mean, Ben, hadn't stuffed off your entire plan. Why didn't you play the idol last night? Do you regret it? Obviously.
Oh, I'm angry at myself. I had faith that Ben saw what I was trying to do. He knew that I had his back. He knew that Jesse had orchestrated the vote on him. And I also thought that Michelle and Khan were on board with what was happening as well, because it worked really well for us leading into the merge. So the one thing I do, you know, stew on is at Tribal Council, I noticed that Khan couldn't look at me, Michelle couldn't look at me. And there was one comment by Jesse that haunts me to this day, and that was how he said, relationships are always changing. There's some relationships that will once again be strong. And, yeah, that should have been a red flag for me to play that idol and know that something was up.
Hey, you entered the game with your sister-in-law, Chrissy, who knew absolutely nothing about the show. How impressed have you been with her game so far?
Oh, so proud. She is so far out of her comfort zone. And like you said, yeah, I did kind of con her into going to the game, and she thought we're going to a tropical island, staying in a resort and just filming on set during the day. So, yeah, but I was always confident in her charisma, her ability to gather people around her and have fun. And I also knew that she was fiercely competitive. So I think she's proven herself in all of those regards throughout the game so far. And not voting with me last night is actually going to play in her favour as well. So, you know, she showed her true colours, that she's a loyal person and she's playing her own game now. So I think that will work in her favour, and, you know, hopefully she can continue to crush it.
Croc, you've played professional football for years. Do you think that's part of the problem, that you're too much of a team player?
Early on, yeah, certainly I love the team aspect of it. So the team challenges, when we won our first tribal immunity, it was one of the best feelings I've ever had since winning big games. So working as a team, I pride myself on bringing positive energy and trying to get the best out of everyone around me. And, you know, we had a really good group. We bonded a lot. We had some really good times together. So that was fun for me. It's just hard when you build those really good relationships that you have to get to the point where you've got to cut the emotion and vote someone out. So, but that's the joy of Survivor. It's such a such a roller coaster of emotion.
It's brutal.
Chrissy seems hungrier than ever to win this game. Do you think she has what it takes?
Oh, absolutely. She has, like I said, proven herself in every aspect of the game. And now that she's learning more and more about it, she's actually picking up a lot on, you know, how to play and what to do and how to deal with people. Her poker face isn't great. That might play against her. She can't hide her emotions very well. However, she built some really good relationships in her original water tribe, you know, Mark and Josh especially. And I think that if, you know, she can get herself to merge and reunite with those guys, they'll again, you know, help her to get further in the game.
I think you owe her a Mai Tai after she gets out of there, after getting her there under false circumstances. Tropical resort.
I've got a hidden immunity idol that I'll give her for Christmas.
So. Very generous.
Well, Australian Survivor, Blood versus Water. It continues tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Croc, thank you so much for joining us. You played a really great game and, yeah, thanks for chatting this morning.
Appreciate it. Enjoy. Thanks, guys.